Hello, in this tutorial, we are going to discuss about a servlet program by using Eclipse. So in order to create a Java EE applications, we have to go to Java EE perspective. Java EE perspective can be selected from Windows option, Windows open perspective, and from other, we can select Java EE. So it will open the Java EE perspective. Then after that, we can create a new dynamic web project from file new, dynamic web project. Or otherwise, we can right click on the project explorer and select new dynamic web project. If it is not listed, we can go to other and select from web. That otherwise, you can type in the wizard dynamic web project. It will be available in the web category. So select dynamic web project, go to next and give a suitable project name. And select the Apache Tomcat. If Apache Tomcat is already configured with Eclipse, it will show in the runtime Apache Tomcat. And go to next. Go to next and click on generate web.xml deployment descriptor checkbox. So web.xml deployment descriptor will get created automatically once you check that checkbox, and click on finish. Now in the project one, we have a set of folders, so Java resources where all the Java files will be stored, and in web content folder, all the HTML pages will get stored in this project. So right click on the project one and add one HTML file, new HTML file. So if it is not visible in the listed files, we can go to other and create HTML file. So give the file name as index.html. Click on next and finish. Now we can modify this HTML file. We are mentioning the title of the project, so home page. And in the body, we are designing the HTML content by using tags and text. We are writing as welcome to dynamic web project. Now, in order to execute this web project, we need the browser. So Eclipse provides an internal browser. So while executing the program, we can see the output in the internal browser, or if we want, we can change the browser to external browser. So the browser can be changed from Windows, Windows option, web browser. So if the output need to be shown in the internal browser, we can click on internal browser. If it needs to be shown separate browser, we can select the respective browser. So we are doing with internal web browser, can be selected from Windows web browser option. So in this program execution, we are using the internal web browser. We can open the server to check whether server is working or not from Windows server option. Tomcat is already configured, so we can click on the Tomcat, right click, and start the Tomcat server. The Tomcat server will get restarted when we execute the project. When we run the project, the Tomcat server will get restart. So in order to execute the project, we can right click on the file and select run as run on server, or we can right click from the file index.html and select run as run on server. So we can see the output get displayed in the browser. It's an internal browser. If you want, we can change it to external browser. So a separate browser will get open and it will show the output. So if you want to make any changes, we can make changes on the file. So we use the bold tag. And after saving the file, we can refresh the web page. So when we refresh the web page, whatever changes we made, that will get reflected in the output. Now we are doing a servlet program for finding a number is even or odd. So right click on the project one and add servlet, new servlet. The servlets can be generally stored. Servlet are the class files, so it can be stored inside a particular package. So we can create any package, Java package. So we are storing our servlet inside a package which is named as perform. And our class name is EOCheck. Go to next. So URL pattern will come, which will be the same name as the class name. We can change that if you want. And go to the next. And we can select the number of abstract methods from the base class. So we are selecting doGet, which is the form analysis method of HTTP servlet class. DoGet can be used to process the HTTP get method. Now in the index.html, we are creating a form with a text box for entering a number. That number needs to be checked as even or odd by the servlet program. We are using the form tag with method as get. An action is the name of the servlet URL pattern, which is the same name as the class name here. So servlet class name is EOCheck. For entering a number, we are creating an input text box by using input tag, input type equal to text, and the name. We have mentioned the name of the text box as T1. So this T1 name need to be used in the servlet in order to get the value from the text box. Next, we are creating a control, which is submit button, by using input tag, input type equal to submit, and the value will be the information that should get displayed on the submit button. So we are writing check even odd as a value of submit button. Now we write the logic for fetching the content from text box T1 and finding whether number what we enter is even or odd in the servlet program. The name of the servlet program is EOCheck, which is stored in the perform package. So we can see the file in the Java resources. Inside perform package, there is a file which is named as eocheck.java. So it will be consist of the package name and various import packages. Annotation a trait web servlet is used to mention the URL pattern of the class, which is same name as the class name. EOCheck is a URL pattern. The servlet class EOCheck is extends from HTTP servlet, and we have included doGet method or form analysis method of HTTP servlet. This method will be overridden for processing the servlet to accept the number from text box and check the number is even or odd. DoGet method takes two parameter, request and response. HTTP servlet request, which is the data coming from HTML file, and HTTP servlet response is used to send the data back to the client. Now by using response, we can mention what type of result we are sending back to client by using set content type response.set content type text/html that mention what type of content we are sending back to client. In order to write some information back to the client, we need printWriter object. So we are creating a printWriter object which is named as out. We have to import the package from IO for printWriter. So click on that and import printWriter java.io. So the respective package need to be imported from IO for printWriter. Now the logic for accepting the value from HTML page and find whether it is even or odd. That number what we enter in the text box is even or odd. We are writing inside a try catch block. Inside the catch block, we are printing the error message out.println, out.println e.get message, which will display the respective runtime errors which will occur during the program execution. Inside the try block, first we have to create a printWriter object. Out is a printWriter object that will be created as response.getWriter method. GetWriter is a method of HTTP servlet response that can be used to create a printWriter object. So out is initialized with response.getWriter. Now, in order to take the value from the text box T1, we have to use a request. Request object is used to take the value from the client. And the method which we have to use is getParameter. And as a parameter for that, we have to mention the name of the control. So name of the control is T1. Request.getParameter of T1 will fetch the value from the text box T1 and it will be in the form of string. So it need to be converted by using integer.parseInt method, which will convert the string number into integer form and it will get stored into the variable n. The HTML tags can be written directly inside the servlet by using out.println. Any HTML tags can be included inside out.println. First, we check whether n is divisible by 2. If it is divisible by 2, we can print that the number n is an even number. So by using out.println, we display the number n and display that it is an even number. Plus symbol is used for concatenation of strings. N is even number. In the else statement, we display the result as n is odd number. Out.println, n is odd number. Now, after saving the program, both file eocheck.java and index.html. So right click on index.html and select run as run on server. The project will get executed and it will show index.html, which will be having a form with one text box. So we enter a value number 2. So it will say that 2 is even number. It is displaying 23. So it will show 23 is odd number. Now, if you want to make some HTML tags to be added with the content, we can include that inside out.println. Now, we want to display even number in blue font. And if the result is odd number, we want to display in the green font. So we can use the font HTML tags inside out.println before we are printing the result. The number is even number. So we start a font tag and make the color as blue. And after displaying the result, we close the font tag. Similarly, if the result is odd number, before starting the display of odd number result, we will change the font. We will use the font tag for changing the font and make the color as green. And after displaying the result, the number is odd number, we will close the font tag. Now, after displaying the result or error message, if you want to go back to the page, the home page, the HTML page from the servlet, we can write the logic inside finally block, where we are making a link to go to the home page by using anchor tag. So in out.println, we are using an anchor tag. So that creates a hyperlink for going to the home page, which is index.html. So from the servlet eocheck.java, we can go back to index.html file. So we are writing inside out.println to go to main page. Then we are using an anchor tag with href. Hyperlink reference is index.html. And we close the anchor tag in click here. So click here will become a hyperlink for going back to the home page index.html. and we close the center tag, which was open before displaying the result. Save the file and refresh the output. So we can see that when we enter an even number, it will display the result in blue font. And to go to main page, we can click. So it is a hyperlink to go back to the index.html. For odd number, it will display in green font. So any HTML tags can be embedded directly inside the servlet inside out.println statement.